I'm Shinichiroh Matsuo from Nagoya University, and thank you very much for inviting me. And yesterday, I went to the Karang, and I was really impressed by the amazingly beautiful blue sky. I'm very happy. So let's start. The title of my talk is Gysin Maps. And bulk edge correspondence. Bulk edge correspondence is a typical feature of topological insulators, and Gysin maps are some natural maps in K theory. And what I want to tell you today is bulk edge correspondence can be understood very clearly in terms of Gysin maps in K theory. In other words, I want to tell you today is topological insulators has a bulk insulating gaps and it also has a conducting edge states. And these edge states are very robust and protected by the non-trivial topology of bulk Hamiltonians, and this is called bulk edge correspondence. And what I want to tell you today is a key point to understand this bulk edge correspondence is the following commutative diagram in K theory. U1 times U1 is a Brillouin zone for two-dimensional topological insulators, and gamma is some curve related to Fermi energy, and I will explain later. And there is another K group, K0 U1 times U1, and there is also K group K0 U1 times gamma. This is U1x, this is U1y, and this is U1xy, and this is U1y. And there is another k minus 1, U1. And these four maps are called Gysin maps. And today I want to tell you this commutative diagram is a key point to understand bulk edge correspondence. And my original motivation comes from differential geometry. I am a differential geometer, especially studying four-dimensional gauge theory, Zeiberg-Whitney theory, which seems to be a completely different field from condensed matter physics. But there are many similarities between Zeiberg-Whitney theory and condensed topological insulator theory. For example, FKMM invariant in Professor Denis's talk is first introduced independently of Fu and Kane in the context of Zeiberg-Whitney theory. And there are another formula in Zeiberg-Whitney theory called wall-crossing formula. This has very, very similar structure to the bulk edge correspondence. This is my motivation. And hopefully I want to import many exciting ideas from condensed matter physics to differential geometry. Now, let's get started. First, I will give you an example. Today, I want to be more concrete, so I want to restrict free fermionic system, periodic, free
fermionic system. Without disorder, and consider a tight binding approximation in order to avoid unbounded operators. And in order to be very concrete, we consider type A topological insulators in two dimensions. So for example, we consider the integer quantum Hall effect. So for example, consider the Hopper operator. This is a bounded operator from L2z to L2z. LKY is a map from L to Z. L to Z is a sequence of L2 summable sequence of complex numbers. Z and KY is a parameter in U1, which is a unit circle in complex plane, and this is given by for um. This is a sequence of complex numbers to HK1. um is given by um plus 1 plus um plus 1 plus 2 foci. And here, phi is some rational number, P over Q. And physically, this corresponds to a magnetic flux per unit. And in order to avoid considering non-commutative geometry, today we restrict phi to be a rational number. So this is a periodic operator from L2 to L2. This is a concrete example. And this has, for each KY, this has a purely continuous spectrum. It's KY. CYY. And the spectrum consists of Q bands. Q is a denominator of the phi. And we vary KY, this consists of bands. And assume Fermi level lies in the spectrum of KY. HKY. This is an insulator assumption. So there exists new real number, and for any KY in U1, mu that is not in the spectrum sigma HKY, a spectrum HKY. So there exists some real number mu. And it does not touch any spectra of HKY. This is my assumption.
And this arises in the two-dimensional integer quantum Hall effect. And in this case, Baruch edge correspondence says that that two numbers associated to these half operators are equal, namely TK and N number. is equal to edge index. This is a Baruch edge correspondence, and next I will explain what these two numbers are. First, I will begin with a TK and N number. HKY is a periodic operator parameterized by KY. So by Fourier or Bloch transform, we get a map from H called HS U1 times U1 to MQ by Q matrices. More concretely, we have H is given by these matrices. H, Kx, Ky is given by Q matrices. Yes. And here is 1, 1, 1, and this is Eikx, and Eikx. So, and by our assumption, by my assumption, we assumed there exists a mu. And for any ky, mu is not in the spectrum. So this corresponds to mu for any kx and ky in U1 times U1. Mu is not the spectrum of HKXKY. Okay. Then define a vector bundle by its following. Define for each KX and KY EKX KY is a linear subspace of CQ spanned by eigenvectors, eigenvectors of HK KY, whose eigenvalues are less than mu. Then consider the vector bundle E. Let E be a union of these E, Kx, Ky. And this is a vector bundle over U1 times U1. By this assumption, we can easily show that these form a vector bundle. In other words, a continuous family of vector spaces. And TKN number is nothing but a C1, first Chern class of this vector bundle. C1, first Chern class of E. This can be computed by the very phase or very connection very concretely. And this is a natural integer. This is a bulk picture. And next we turn to edge picture. Edge index. In order to introduce edge index, we consider a Dirichlet problem associated to this HKY. So this is x direction, and this is y direction. And we consider the Dirichlet problem in this half plane, namely dd of hky on n, positive integers. Then hky defines bounded operator from a to n to l to n. Its spectrum consists of following diagram, a following picture. This is the ky direction. And this is sigma kxy, hky. And the spectrum for each hky consists of a continuous spectrum and eigenvalues. This is the same as a bulk Hamiltonian. But new feature for this Dirichlet problem is the existence of eigenvalues. So this is called eigenvalues, and this is a continuous spectrum. So the Fermi level might touch eigenvalues of some HKXY, and edge index is defined to be the signed count of this touching number. Crossing point.
of mu and eigenvalues of HKY.
And this is an integer. And Bulk edge corresponds, Bulk edge correspondence states that these two numbers are equal. This is a very concrete picture, and I will be in the next section. I will be more abstract, and I will introduce a case theoretic picture. So let X be a compact Hausdorff space. For example, X is E1 in this case. And let V be a complex, finite dimensional complex vector bundle, complex vector space. In this case, V is CQ, C to the Q, and V is all linear maps from V to V. In this case, and V is nothing but the map space of matrices, Q by Q matrices, and define a continuous map H from X times U1 to end V is called a gapped Hamiltonian. If the following condition is satisfied, there exists a gamma. This is a closed curve in the compressed plane, and the condition is that for any kx and ky in x times u1, and for any lambda in gamma, hkx ky minus lambda is invertible as a linear map from v to v. And this gamma is the same as this gamma. And Fourier transformed Hopper operator is an example of this gapped Hamiltonian. This condition says for each kx, ky, hkx, ky is nothing but the matrices, so it has a q eigenvalues in the complex plane. And these eigenvalues does not lie in this curve gamma. This is a condition, and this is an abstract version of Fermi level. And we will define a two invariant, bulk invariant and bulk index and edge index for these two, this gapped Hamiltonian. Let me begin with a bulk index. And fix a gapped Hamiltonian. H and gamma. Then define as in the same way for each kx and ky in u1 x times u1 ekx ky is a linear subspace of our subspace of V spanned by eigenvectors of h k s k y with eigenvalues inside the gamma. In this symmetry class, it is not important, but in other symmetry class, it's important.
But I don't understand, because you can have a Hamiltonian which has a continuous spectrum on the real axis. This is, of course, is not gapped, but you can choose a curve
but, plane. But this is Fourier transform version. So each HKX, KY consists of only eigenvalues, because this is nothing but a Q by Q matrices. For example, for Harpo beta, a spectrum consists only, eigenvalue consists only real values. So and we take, there exists a Fermi level mu, and the gamma is a foreign. This is example gamma.
You're saying you have other options.
Huh?
You have other options to avoid the eigenvalues.
Ah, yes, yes. If there are other options, for example, this is an example of gamma, but we get a trivial invariant. Thank you. And define the vector bundle E over X times U1 as in the same way. And in this case, TKN number is a first chunk class of this bundle, but this bundle itself defines an invariant in K theory. And bulk index of H gamma is K theoretic class, which defined by this bundle itself in K0 of X times U1. For example, if X equal is equal to U1, then K0 of U1 times U1 is isomorphic to Z times Z plus Z. And this isomorphism is given by E to rank of E and the Chern class of E. And this is nothing but a TKNN number. So this bulk index, K theoretic version, is a refinement of a TKNN number. Next, we turn to the edge picture. And so I define if this is x, this x, x, then I define the bulk index here. H index. Edge index is defined in terms of the Dirichlet problem of Hamiltonian, and in terms of the Fourier transformed Hamiltonian, it corresponds to the Tapered operator, and I will introduce Tapered operator. And before doing that, I have to introduce Hardy space. Hardy space denoted by H2 U1 C is a closed linear subspace of L2 and spanned by Z to the K, and K is non-negative. And this corresponds by a Fourier transform, L2 to N, and we define A2 U1, P2 V, tensor product of A2 U1 C times V. This is a Hardy space and nothing but L to N. And define a orthonormal projection from L2 to H2 by pi. This condition, gapped Hamiltonian, the condition for gapped Hamiltonian, ensures that for each kx and lambda in x times gamma, the operator from U1 to GLV, which is K1, holds to HKX, K1 minus lambda. A gapped Hamiltonian condition ensures that these matrices HKX, K1 minus lambda is invertible. So this condition is nothing but this map from U1 to the image of this map is in invertible matrices, GLV. Then we define edge Hamiltonian. This is a Fourier transformed version of Dirichlet problem. And for each kx and ky, kx and lambda, kx times gamma, we do not H KX and lambda from Hardy space to Hardy space. It's defined by U to first fiber, we do a fiber-wise multiplication by this matrices, and then we operate an orthogonal projection. Then define its image is in Hardy space, and this is the definition of edge Hamiltonian.
Pardon?
The pi that you have there is the projection on the RV space from the L2?
Yes, pi is an orthogonal projection from L2 to Hardy space. And we have
that gives you the Dirichlet operator.
Pardon?
That gives you the Dirichlet.
Dirichlet?
On the half space. You, in your example, you take the Harper operator. You started from Harper on.
Yes. Yes. And in order to define edge index, we consider Dirichlet problem. And in a Fourier transform picture, that Dirichlet problem corresponds to this Hardy problem, Hardy space operator. Called the tapered operator. And the proposition is because by gapped condition HKX, KY minus lambda is invertible, this familial operator is a familial Fred Hall operators. KX lambda to H edge KX lambda is a continuous family of Fredholm operators. And if we are given a continuous family of Fredholm operators, we get an element of K-theory group. And this is nothing but our version of edge index. Denoted by E in of H gamma is an element defined by this family, continuous family of Fredholm operators. And we define edge index. And the bulk edge correspondence states that these two invariants are equal. But before doing that, I want to introduce another invariant, which is a novelty of our argument. Gap index. This invariant trivializes bulk edge correspondence. So H gamma is gapped Hamiltonian. So gapped Hamiltonian means for x 1 times gamma, so kx times ky, lambda goes to hk. X, ky, and lambda. Minus lambda, and gapped condition means this is invertible. So this is an element of GLV. So we get a map by gapped Hamiltonian, but we get a map from x times u1 times gamma to GLV. And this is homotopy equivalent to uv. And if we are given a map from some topological space to uv, we get an element of K-theory group. Definition gap index, G index of H gamma is an element defined by this map itself. And this map, this element lives in K1 of x times u1 times gamma. So gap index here
And my proposition is the following. And there is a trivial vibration x times u1 times gamma to the forgetful map from x times u1 gamma to u1 forgetting gamma, and another forgetful map is x times gamma forgetting u1. Then given this vibration, we have a Gysin map push forward in K theory. This is not by gamma exponential map from K1 such U1 gamma to K0 of X times U1, and similarly pi U1 and my proposition is position is the image of Gysin map, image of gap index by this Gysin map is nothing but a bulk index. And similarly, image of gap index by this Gysin map is nothing but edge index. This is almost trivial by construction. And so what I have just said is this map goes to this element goes to this, and this goes to this. And consider another forgetful maps, X forgetting U1 and forgetting gamma. This diagram trivially commutes because this goes to kx, ky to lambda. This goes to kx and ky. And next forget ky. And this forget ky. And next forget lambda, then this map commutes. If this map commutes, then associate Gysin maps also commute. This is the functoriality of Gysin maps. So this diagram commutes. And so this goes to some element. But these images coincide because there exists a Gysin gap index. This goes to go, this goes to go, and this goes to go, and this diagram commutes. So this proves a bulk edge correspondence. So next 5 minutes, I want to touch on.
These multiple maps? I mean, how does it prove?
Oh, so formally, this is proven by. What I want to prove is edge index is equal to pi u1 of bulk index. This is because this is nothing but pi gamma of pi u1 gap index, and because of that proposition, and by the functoriality of this map, this is pi gamma composed with pi u1. this is equal to this, and because this diagram commutes, this is equal to pi u1 and pi gamma exclamation mark of g int, and this is nothing but pi u1 pi gamma g index, and this is equal to bulk index, and this proves bulk index, bulk edge correspondence.
Well, up to the last sentence, I totally agree. Is it possible that there is no information left after that?
For example, for a hub operator, the image of the bulk index is nothing but a TKNN number, and image of this number is nothing but the edge index in the Hubble case. So this recovers, for example, type A, bulk edge corresponds for type A each letter. And generalization. So for other symmetric type, then we use KR groups. So other symmetric corresponds to a Clifford action for KR groups, and we use corresponding KR group, but there are many descriptions to define KR groups. For example, Karoubi's description and Atiyah-Zinga type description. And bulk index is defined in terms of Karoubi type description. Of KR. And edge index is defined in terms of Atiyah-Zinga type by using Fredholm operators here. And in order to introduce more general, in more general setting of our gap index, we have introduced new definition of KR groups, which combines both Karoubi type and Atiyah-Zinga type, and this yields a new comparison theorem between Karoubi type description and Atiyah-Zinga type description, and it also gives a new proof of very, very elementary proof of Bott periodicity. And this concludes my talk. Thank you very much.